I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God. With a woof woof here and a woof woof there, here a woof, there a woof, everywhere a woof woof.
I want you to be my VP. I want you. You're my vice.
Well, George, I'm the CEO of a large company. And I have been Secretary of Defense. And I have been White House Chief of Staff. The vice presidency is a mostly symbolic job.
That's Sam Rockwell as George W. Bush offering Dick Cheney, played by Christian Bale, a position as vice president in the new dramedy Vice. I'm Chris Zweig. This is a mixed review from me to you.
What I admire about Vice is the way director Adam McKay steps outside his comfort zone to tackle political issues, whether he wants them to be funny or serious. And he does a brilliant job of casting Bale as Dick, Amy Adams as his wife Lynn, and Steve Carell as Donald Rumsfeld. But what drowns my interest is how campy it gets, and how its talk about politics may leave some uninterested or confused based on their beliefs. I myself try to get involved as much as possible to understand.
When you have power, people will always try to take it from you, always.
There are moments in Vice that I thought were either funny or informative, depending on how the director portrays them, and moments that go on too long. Again, McKay has the guts to expand his horizons, but it's just too campy for me to praise. This is one of those see-what-you-think deals.
Well, that's my mixed review of Vice. If you like this review and other reviews coming up, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, and my written reviews are at www.cjatthemovies.com. I'm Chris Zweig, and I'll see you at the movies.